Hello friends, welcome to our channel Knowledge Amplifier. So today in my this particular video, I am going to discuss one very interesting application of erosion, that is morphological image processing technique, right? And that is in granulometry. So I hope you know about grains, and suppose we are having a picture of grains. Now we are asked to get the size distribution. Then that kind of study comes under granulometry. Okay, so in granulometry we mainly try to get the measurement of the size distribution of grains. Okay, so what is that particular use case? Let me discuss that first. Okay, so you are having a large number of particles of different size but approximately similar shape. Okay, size is different but shape is similar. Suppose one particular image is there, and there basically you are having different circular objects. Okay, one is small circular, one is bigger circular, one is very small, okay, one is very big, like that. Okay, so this kind of picture contains similar shape but different size, right? So I hope you can understand these two word, which plays a very important role in this particular study. Okay, so you are having a large number of particles of different size but approximately similar shape, and the requirement or the problem statement is to rapidly estimate the probability distribution of particle sizes. Okay, so the different sizes of particles are present in the image. You are asked to get the probability distribution, okay, of particle sizes, that this much, this many number of particles, like suppose 20 or 30 particles are coming under this much size, 50 particles are coming under this much size, like that you have to give the distribution. And this is the use case. That time this technique you can use in this particular context which I am going to discuss. Okay, right? So let's try to understand what we can do. So suppose our original image looks like this. You can understand that this image contains similar shape, that is circular shape, but having different size. Okay, objects are present, and the requirement is we need to calculate the size distribution. Okay, there is probability distribution of size, right? So basically, maybe like in x-axis there will be some measurement related to size. Suppose maybe radius as 1 unit, radius as 2 unit, radius as 3 unit, like that. Under 1 unit radius, how many particles? Suppose 10 particles are coming, then here maybe this point will be 1, 10. Okay, then under radius 2, maybe 20 particles are coming, then this will be 2, 20. Okay, so like this you have to give the distribution. So that is the problem statement, and we are given the image as input, right? So how we can solve this? Try to understand these steps. I'll be explaining each of them. Once the explanation will be in a complete mode, you can understand or relate all these steps. Okay, primarily these steps might appear some complicated or confusing, but just be with me throughout the video. I am sure that you will understand what is happening. Okay, so here we are going to use erosion. Just a quick recap of erosion. What erosion does? We are having one binary image, we are having a structuring element. If the structuring element fits on a binary on a part of the binary image, that time the central pixel will be remaining. If it is, if the structural element is not fitting, then the particular elements will wash away, right? So suppose this is our binary image. Okay, so this particular shade is indicating 1 pixels or pixels having value as 1, and this particular kind of pixels are denoting 0 pixel. Okay, right? So 0 means black, 1 means white. This is binary image, right? And we are having a structuring element of plus shape. Okay, so see 1, 1, 1, like it is making one plus symbol, right? Now what will happen, where this structuring element will fit? See, very simple. If you consider this as center, here this structuring element will fit, right? Okay, I drawn wrong way. Let me just erase this and show you. So here the structuring element will fit. Another case will be, let me change the color. Okay, and if you choose the center, if you choose the center here, see here also like this way 1 pixels, and up down also 1 pixels. Here also structuring element will match. That means this region and this region will be as they are matching, so this will be remaining in the output image. But see, anywhere else you, if you just move around this particular structuring element, those will not fit. okay, and as a result those pixels will wash away. So this is the output of erosion, right? So this is just a fundamental recurve of erosion technique. I discussed how you can implement the erosion using MATLAB inbuilt function without using inbuilt function, all those, right? You can check my earlier videos in the image processing playlist. Okay, now coming to the algorithm, what algorithm we are going to follow? The step one is we begin the process by first counting total number of objects present. Okay, so what we do in the first step? In the first step, we count how many objects are present in the image. So for that, we can write this piece of code. Very simple, CLC clear all close all warning off as we generally write, nothing new here. Then we are reading the image enamel.tif, okay, converting from RGB to gray, okay, and then we are converting to double format, okay, because here we are going to apply different arithmetic operation, and if you are encountering arithmetic, always it is better to convert from unsigned integer 8-bit representation to double format, right? I have discussed this several times. And then showing that image, okay, title we can give as original image. Then in a new figure window, we are basically applying thresholding using im to bw and specifying this particular threshold. This particular threshold you can get by heat and trial. Whatever threshold value is giving properly, you can choose that. And point to be noted, here I am taking complement of the thresholded binary image. The reason is very simple. In this particular input image, you can see that our foreground objects are black, background objects are white. But what we do generally while discussing any image related to morphological context, we consider our foreground object as white, background object as black. That's why I am taking here complement to follow that particular convention. That's it, nothing else. Okay, then here I am showing the binary image and giving the title as binary image. Then while doing thresholding, it might happen that some holes might appear in our image. So let's fill the holes. This is nothing but coming under image pre-processing concept, right? Whatever I have discussed. So we are doing image filling, a hole filling algorithm. And then here we are showing binary image after hole filling. And then we are counting what are the total number of objects present initially, okay? L, num0, that is second output parameter of BW label function, gives us number of binary objects, right? So this is our num0, which is our requirement in this stage. We begin the process by first counting total number of objects present, right? So I hope how you can do this, it is very clear to you, okay? Then coming to the next step, the image is then repeatedly eroded using the same structuring element until no object remains, okay? That is, in this particular context, you can understand, if we want to apply erosion, we will be taking disk shape structuring element, right? Because here our objects are circular shape. We will keep on doing erosion, okay? Suppose this is our original image is I. We are applying erosion with the structuring element of this disk shape. I am getting I1. On this I1, I will again apply same structuring element and erosion, I'll be getting I2. On I2, I'll be again applying erosion using same structuring element, I'll be getting I3. And eventually what is happening? When you keep on going applying these erosion techniques again and again, basically all the foreground objects will shrink and shrink, and eventually they will start getting disappeared, okay? And one time, if we keep on doing this, there will be a certain time when there will be no object remaining in this image, okay? So that's what is written here. The image is then repeatedly eroded using the same structuring element, okay? We are not changing the structuring element, okay? Suppose maybe we can initiate with disk shape structuring element with size 2 or 1, okay? That depends on the use case, whatever we are encountering, okay? The initial structuring element and the same one will keep on that is applying as erosion technique on our binary image, okay? Until no objects remains, okay? And in each stage of erosion, what we will be doing, this is very important. At each step in this process, we record the total number of objects F, okay, which have been removed from the image as a function of the number of erosion N, okay? So what is done here? Let me explain again. So suppose my initial image is I, we are applying erosion, we are getting I1, okay? On I1, we will be applying BW label function and we will be counting how many binary objects are there. Suppose binary remaining binary objects are N1, and in this initial image, the binary objects we already calculated, that is N0, right, which is written here. see num underscore 0. This is our initial number of binary objects, right? So at the initial stage, number of binary objects is n naught. Then we are applying erosion, we are having n1. That means what? N naught minus n1, that is those many number of binary objects are disappeared in the first attempt of erosion. Okay, then again we are applying erosion using same structuring element and we are getting the image I2. This is another binary image. On this we are applying BW label and we are counting how many binary objects are there. Suppose we are getting n2. Okay, so n0 minus n2, that means what? N0 minus N2, that is initial number of binary objects minus current number of binary objects, that is those many number, that subtraction result is indicating those many number of binary objects are removed at the second time of erosion, like this. Okay, that's what is written here. At each step of the process, we record total number of objects which have been removed from the image as a function of number of erosion. Okay, so basically how many objects are removed compared to initial one. So this subtraction result is basically function of number of erosion n. Okay, how many times we are doing this erosion, because if we keep on increasing number of erosion, that is n value, then more and more objects will be removed, right? So this result of subtraction at each stage, how many binary objects are remaining, that if you subtract from the initial number of binary objects, that will be a function of number of erosions, right? At that stage, how many times erosion you have applied, right? I hope you can easily understand. Now that is our key to get the size distribution of the grains, okay, or of the enamel. So how, let me discuss that. So the code will look like this. Here we are, up to this I hope I have discussed that we are applying BW label and we are getting initial number of binary objects, and then BW equal to binary field, we are just making, changing the variable, that's it. We are nothing doing something else, that now currently BW contains our actual binary image, and then here we are basically making our initial structuring element, which is having disk shape of radius 2, and then here we are making count equal to 0 and num equal to num naught. Okay, and we'll be using this while loop until and unless, that is num equal to 0. Okay, that is when there will be no object remaining in that binary image, that time only we'll break this while loop. While num greater than 0, we are keep on incrementing the count value, that is how many times we are doing this erosion. We are applying im erode function, that is we are doing erosion on our binary image using the structuring element. Then we are recomputing the number of binary objects present in that particular image instance. Okay, and that we are storing in a p array. Okay, p of count equal to our initial number of binary objects, that is num naught, which we computed here. Okay, minus at the current stage how many binary objects are there. Okay, so see, this particular p is a vector which is function of count. Okay, count is indicating what? Count is indicating how many times we are applying this erosion on our image, right? And then when there will be no binary object remain in our image, that time number will be 0 and the while loop will be the code will come out of the while loop, and then we are plotting here. And in the plotting, what we are doing, we are not directly plotting, we are at the front side, we are appending 0. Okay, so basically what I want to plot, so I want to plot like this way. In x axis there will be how many times I have to apply erosion, and in the y axis it will be how number of objects removed. Okay, so when there is at 0th instance, when we have applied no erosion, that time no object is removed, right? So basically here we are appending 0 in the number of objects removed. Similarly here in the x axis also we are starting from 0 to count. Okay, that's it. So plot 0 to count p, and we are giving this line style as ro, that is circular kind of line style. This discrete distribution will come and the color will be red. Okay, that's why r, and o indicate this kind of circular line style will come. Okay, so basically this will be our distribution. So in x axis it is indicating number of erosions, in the y axis it is indicating particles removed. Okay, see, this p value is indicating what? This p is storing how many particles are removed at that particular stage due to application of nth time erosion, right? That is num naught, initial number of binary objects minus current stage number of binary objects, right? Which is function of number of erosions we are applying on that image, okay? Right? So here this figure is indicating the same. In the x-axis, number of erosions is plotted, okay? So when number of erosions 0, that is no erosion is applied, no particle is removed, okay? When number of erosion is 1, okay, that is we are applying erosion of with the structuring element having disk shape and radius 2, that is when we are doing first time erosion, that time nearly 43, okay, so this particular axis is indicating particles removed, you can see approximately 43, okay, so 43 pixels are removed, okay, at the second time of erosion, this value is nearly approximately coming like 65 maybe, okay, we can get this exact value from MATLAB, no issue. So 65 particles or binary objects are removed due to second time iteration, okay, and this is giving us idea of the size distribution. Why? Very simple, number of erosions, see this very carefully and try to feel this, number of erosions required to make an object vanish is directly proportional to its size. Obviously, right? Suppose I am having a very small binary object and I am having a fixed or constant structuring element. Maybe the structuring element at this stage is matching with this binary object. So once we apply erosion, what will happen? This particular complete part of the binary image will become converted to a single pixel, and at the next erosion, at the next iteration, it will not match with this structuring element and it will vanish, okay? But rather, suppose I am having a very big binary object present in our binary image. Now, to make this particular binary object vanish using a constant structuring element, we need to apply erosion multiple times, okay? That is, number of erosions required to make an object vanish is directly proportional to its size. So, this particular picture is indicating what? That is, 43 binary objects are present in our grains image or that enamel image, which are quite small, due to which by applying the erosion first time only 43 objects are vanished, okay? Then next time when we are applying second time erosion, what is happening? Due to application of second time erosion, total 65 binary objects are vanishing, but this 65 is compared to initial stage, okay? Actually, in the second stage of application of erosion, newly 65 minus 43, that is newly 22 binary objects are getting vanished, okay? Right? Like this way. So what you can do, you can basically subtract consecutive y values and you can get the idea that at each stage of erosion, at each stage of successive erosions, newly how many particles or binary objects are getting washed away or vanishes, okay? And that is basically nothing but giving us an idea of size of that particle, because suppose at kth iteration one particular particle is getting vanished or one particular binary object is vanished, then we can say that the size of the binary object is approximately, suppose x, that x will be approximately equal to alpha times k, okay, where k is kth iteration, at which iteration the particle is getting vanished, okay, and alpha is a proportionality constant, okay, which depends on the structuring element. Suppose the structuring alpha can be the area of the structuring element, okay. So basically what this indicating, that suppose the structuring the binary object is bigger, then more number of iterations will be required, right? So the k value will be more, okay? So k multiplied by alpha will be giving us the idea that, okay, this the binary object is actually having bigger size, that's why the k value is more. So like this way you can get the idea, right? Now, so this is our kind of cumulative thing, because this 65 is indicating at second iteration totally how many binary objects are removed compared to our initial image, okay? But actually 22 new binary objects removed, because at the first iteration only 43 binary objects washed away, okay? Newly when we are applying second time iteration, newly 22 more binary objects are removed. That's why 22 plus 43, it is resulting to 65 binary objects removal. Okay, right? As simple as that. So to get the exact size distribution, what you can do, you can make subtraction. Okay, so maybe 43 minus 0, that is 43 only. So 43 in the first iteration, 65 minus 43, 22 in the second iteration. So those are basically a kind of size distribution will be, right? So what we can do, we can make diff function, because differentiation, we are kind of doing differentiation only, right? 65 minus 43, then this element minus 65, like this way. So this is nothing but called differentiation, right? That is discrete differentiation, we can say. And if we do discrete differentiation, we will be getting this kind of shape. Here number of iterations, and this is size density. Okay, so what it is indicating, at the first iteration 43, this is 43, 40 and 45 middle value, little bit upward direction. So this is 43 binary objects are having this size, or the size corresponding to or proportional to first time iteration. Okay, then there are 22. Okay, this particular value is nearly getting 22. So 22 binary objects are getting washed away at the second time of erosion. So that 22 binary objects are having the size corresponding to alpha 2, that is 2 alpha. Okay, 2 is the second time iteration and alpha is the proportionality constant depending on the structuring element area or structuring element whatever we are using. Like for example here, this is disk shape, right? At the third iteration, this is nearly coming as 13 kind of thing. So 13 binary objects are removed. Okay, so this number of iterations are giving us the approximate idea of size density. So what it is indicating, 43 binary objects are very small. Okay, because they are getting washed away at the first instance only, first iteration only. Then if you keep on doing this way, say at the 14th erosion iteration, the small number of binary objects are getting washed away. So that is indicating very small binary objects are there, which is having very huge size. That's why this many number of iterations are required. Okay, and after 14, if you keep on doing, then there is no binary object remaining in the image. Okay, so this is kind of giving us the shape distribution, right? So let us go to MATLAB and show you the same. So here is the code, CLC clear all close all warning off. We are taking IM to double as I have discussed. Then here I am showing our original image. Here histogram I am plotting, but the histogram is not required. This I was checking for getting the idea of the thresholding. Okay, for the time being, let me remove that. And then here I am doing figure and then converting that image to binary image, filling the holes. Okay, then getting the initial count of binary objects. Then we are keep on doing erosion until and unless there is no object remaining. At each stage of erosion, we are basically storing the value that how many objects are washed away, okay, compared to initial number, okay, num not minus num, and then we are plotting that. So for this particular figure, x-axis will be number of erosion, y-axis will be number of particles removed, okay, but this number of particles removed will be cumulative kind of thing. That is, I have shown you, right? That is, at the second instance, 65 particles removed. That means 65 compared to beginning. But actually, at the first instance only, 43 particles already removed. Okay? So, 65 minus 43, that is 22 new particles got removed due to second iteration. Okay? That is, there are 22 particles which are having size proportional to the second time iteration. Okay, that is 22 particles having the size approximately equal to alpha multiplied by 2, like that way. Okay, so to get that value, I am doing diff function. Okay, and then plotting that. So if I just run the whole code, it might take some time. So here is the different figure window. In the first figure window, this is our binary image. In the second figure window, this is our binary image. The first figure window is our actual grayscale image. Okay, here wrong labeling is coming. Let me correct that. So I am show here. Let me give figure. Okay, and I am show original image. Then here binary image, and then here I am fill. Yeah, now I think we are good. Let me run this again. So this is our original image. This is our binary image. You can see many holes are present. Let us fill the holes there. So this is our binary image after hole filling. Then this is the cumulative kind of distribution, number of erosion. So number of erosion, this is basically giving us the size idea. Okay. And this is number of particles removed. And actual our size density looks like this. Okay. So as if number of erosions, if we are going towards right hand side of x-axis, that means the particle size is becoming bigger and bigger, because that many number of erosions are required, more number of erosions are required to remove that particular pixel from binary image. Okay. And this is our size density. So this is how you can get the size distribution from image. Okay. And this is the study of granulometry. I hope you have understood this, got some essence or idea. There is one MathWorks documentation beautifully created based on this particular use case, but that particular algorithm is little bit different. They have tried to apply the same concept on snowflake image, that is snow falling from sky. On that, how it will how to compute the distribution of size, like that they have tried to compute. You can explore that. I'll be providing the link in the description box, and this is all for my this video. Code I'll be providing in the description box. No need to worry about the code. Okay. So if you find this video helpful, then please like, share and comment. Subscribe my channel if you have not subscribed till now, and don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of my latest videos. Thank you.